So you were just elected to the National Academy of Engineering, which is the highest professional distinction bestowed upon engineers. Congratulations.
Thank you.
The moment when you found out, can you describe that?
Actually, I was at a coffee hour with Dean Howard, and the coffee hour was just ending, and I happened to look at my phone for the messages, and I saw that there was an email from NAE telling me that I had been elected. It was a mixture of excitement and disbelief. It's like, is it real? Is it really happening? I didn't say anything to anybody. I just walked back to my department, and there was a FedEx envelope waiting for me with a letter inside telling me that I was elected to NAE.
I assume you received a flood of emails, calls, and texts from friends and colleagues. What was their reaction to the news?
Actually, that was the most surprising part. I got so many messages, phone calls, flowers from colleagues, friends, alumni, former students, and from all over the world. And that really meant so much to me. It was very moving, very touching. And also seeing the joy and excitement that my own colleagues in this department felt really meant a lot to me.
You were elected for your research in electro-catalysis and elucidation of mechanisms of oxidation catalysis. What problems is this work solving or trying to solve?
So we are working on real problems, whether it is converting carbon dioxide to value as a chemicals or developing precious metal-free electrocatalysts for fuel cells so they can become more available, accessible, or whether we're trying to make ammonia from just nitrogen and water, or cleaning water, which has been contaminated with halogenated hydrocarbons. We're really working on real problems. And that's the message that I try to convey to my students, that what we're working on has some real meaning.
So March 8th is International Women's Day, which celebrates the social, economic, cultural, and political achievements of women. It also marks a call to action for accelerating women's equality. So what words of inspiration would you offer to aspiring women engineers?
There are successes as well as failures. So it is important not to get discouraged, not to give up, but just keep charging on. And I also mentioned that kindness is so important, because I don't think we have enough kindness in this world. And when I say kindness, I mean kindness for the people around us, but also kindness to ourselves.
Now, you've been a Buckeye engineer since 1985, I believe, and you've served in many leadership roles, so you must really like it here. How would you describe your Ohio State experience to someone who's unfamiliar?
So I started at Ohio State as a young assistant professor right after I got my PhD. And I grew up here both personally and professionally. And Ohio State has been a great place, has given me many, many opportunities. I have also been blessed having extremely talented young men and women work in my group. And that really makes the journey so much more enjoyable. So I'm extremely loyal to Ohio State. I guess you could say that I bleed scarlet and gray.